This is the story of a man living in the United States in the 1970s. He desperately wants to become an actor, but things aren't going his way. He is dead broke, can't pay his bills, and he's got quarrels with his wife all the time because he does want to take on a normal job. He knows that once he starts earning a regular wage, he will slowly but surely forget his dream of becoming an actor and just live his life like an ordinary Joe. He hates that idea, and he would rather live on the streets than become, like everyone else, a wage slave. In a last attempt to get luck on his side, he decides to take his dog and best friend Butkus and take a train ride to Los Angeles to try and breathe life into his acting career. Because after all, that is where all the great Hollywood studios are, and it makes sense to him because he could audition for several roles in a day without needing a car. As it is, he can't afford one. But California doesn't really seem to change his destiny, and still studios reject him daily and don't want him as an actor. To be fair, what makes it twice as hard for him is the fact that the lower left part of his chin is paralyzed, which gives him kind of a slurring speech, and that sounds unique to say the least. He's desperately running out of money and spends his afternoons in the library because it is warm inside, and surrounded by all these books, he decides to write screenplays and goes into a frenzy of writing play after play after play and offering them to the studios. But again, he gets rejected all the time. In fact, he gets rejected over 1,000 times. Not able to afford food for his dog any longer, he goes down to the liquor store and sells him for $25 to a stranger. That is the lowest point he has ever faced in life, and he feels devastated. He can't believe what he'd just done, and he goes to a nearby bar to drown his sorrows with the last money he's got. While drinking his whiskey, he notices a boxing match that is showing on TV. It is Muhammad Ali against the underdog Chuck Wepner. Really, this guy, who is regarded as a stumblebum by the boxing community and his family, should be cannon fodder for Ali. And no one really knows how he got the fight in the first place, but somehow, he always gets back up when Ali hits him. He even manages to send Ali to the canvas once, and fights his heart out for the entire 15 rounds without Ali knocking him out. Of course, he loses on points, but he manages a moment of eternity against the greatest boxer of all time. For these 15 rounds, Chuck Wepner isn't a loser or a bum. He is a remarkable and vicious boxer. Our hero immediately goes back to his tiny apartment and starts writing a phenomenal script about a white working-class guy from Philadelphia who, against all odds, gets a shot for the heavyweight title of the world in boxing. He sends the script to all the studios, but again, no one wants to touch his story. One day, while auditioning for a role as an actor, after being rejected once again on his way out, he suddenly turns around and remembers that he's got the script in the bag, and shouts to the producers that he's got an amazing story, which they should check out. Reluctantly, they take it and promise him to read it. So after 2 days, he gets a call from the studio that they want to make the movie. They offer him $365,000 for the script. But being who he is, he declines, because they won't let him play the lead role. After hours of negotiating, they give him the lead role, as he agrees to only take $35,000 for the script. So he declines the big money for a chance to become a famous actor. It's a huge risk. But he knows that if the movie gets successful without him in it, he will regret it for the rest of his life. The first thing he does after sealing the deal with the studio is he runs back to the liquor store and stays there for 2 days. Until the stranger walks by with his dog. He tells him that he has money now, and he wants his dog back. But the guy doesn't want to hear any of it. so he offers him over $2,000 and a small part in the movie. He gets to play the referee in the big fight. The man agrees. And so he goes on to produce the movie with a budget from the studio. He uses friends and family for bit part roles to save money. And most of the shots are made in just one take, with handheld cameras. He finishes the movie. And the big coming out for the film, before hitting the theater, is a screening for the Directors Guild in Hollywood. He's got his mother with him, and the theater is packed with around 900 people, all from the film industry. It's not going well. They don't laugh where laughs should be, and the fight scenes are not eliciting any response at all. One by one, people start leaving the cinema, until our hero and his mother are the only ones left. She tells him that he can come back home, put his life back together, get a job, and so on. He guides his mother down the 3 flights of stairs to the lobby. And suddenly, he sees the entire audience down there waiting for him. And they start applauding wildly. Sylvester Stallone starts crying. Tears of joy, and all the hard work suddenly pays off. Rocky goes on to receive 9 Oscar nominations, 3 wins, including Best Picture. The movie that was made for less than $1 million with handheld cameras brought in over $200 million worldwide. Now think about that. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is the story of how Sylvester Stallone became famous. So whatever hardship you face in life, and whenever you feel like giving up, don't. Because you never lose as long as you don't give up. Thanks for watching. And stay blessed. Ah, by the way, that's Butkus.